I have trouble here, living here in Japan though. I'm trying to learn Japanese. It's pretty tough. Anyone else trying to learn Japanese?
You!
Yes!
You trying to learn Japanese? Are you the one that's on the JET program? You're on the JET program, great. How's your Japanese going? What level would you say you are? Think about it. Think about it.
A little bit above beginner.
A little bit above beginner. Okay. When I got here 3.5 years ago, I was Scoshy level. You know Scoshy level? It basically translates as shit. That's what Scoshy level is. 3.5 years later, I am still at Scoshy level. So, if anything, I'm consistent. Right? Consistency is important these days. But the reason for my lack of improvement is not because I don't study. It's not because I spend all my time telling jokes in English and hanging out with English people. It's not because I've developed a unique language of grunts and points like, This is working pretty well for me. But the reason is because Japanese textbooks are out to get me. The Japanese textbooks are out to get me. It's a conspiracy, people. Forget the moon landing, forget JFK. The Japanese textbooks are the real conspiracy. And I'll tell you why. They want to get us out. They want to get a big tax bill and get us out. Because inside the Japanese textbook, the Japanese has no relation to real Japanese. I'll give you an example. You need one, clearly. So in the Japanese textbook I have, there's 8 pages on conjugating verbs. There should be 5 pages on hair and 3 pages on nandake. I actually, in my Japanese textbook, there's a big section on saying goodbye, right? There's many ways you can say goodbye. If you say sayonara, but it's pretty final, it means fuck off out of my life and never come back. There's oyasumi nasai, meaning good night, but it's a little bit sexual. A bit creepy. I don't need that kind of trouble in my life right now, really. And there's otsukare sama deshita, which frankly nobody knows what that means. Not even the Japanese. No. Ask a Japanese person, what's a good translation for otsukare sama deshita? Like, it doesn't really translate into English. Like, yeah, it doesn't exist. It's not a real word. That's right. But I was, first time I came here, I was having a drink with a Japanese friend just after I landed, really, and came time at the end of the evening to say goodbye and part ways. And suddenly I had this internal crisis. I was like, oh my God, what do I say? Do I say sayonara? No, I don't want him to leave the country. maybe oyasumi nasai. No, we're just friends. I don't want to take the relationship to that level. Otsukare sama desu. No, definitely not. That's not a real word. Use real words. Use real words. While I'm having this internal crisis, my Japanese friend just goes, Ja! What? What on earth did you say? Ja! It's not in the textbook. Wait, Ja, if you're talking about reggae, I own Bob Marley Legend on CD, I have the poster on my wall, we can talk about Ja Rastafari, Big Up Selassie I all night, but that is not a goodbye in Japanese, okay? That was a great clap. I'm not sure what that was a clap for. It sounded like a sex clap, one person just like, yeah, I did great. Another time, I was out for dinner with some gaijin foreign friends of mine. They all speak pretty hot Japanese, so I tried to impress them. Now, as you know, in the Japanese textbooks, when you refer to I, the word is watashi, right? That's all it uses in the book. I was like, fine, watashi, I can use that. How about watashi wa Alex desu, my name is Alex. Watashi ga toire ikimashita. If you want to tell someone you've just been to the toilet, maybe you do. I know I need to say that sometimes to people, just to give them a little warning. So, you know, I turned to my friends all proud. I was like, watashi ga toire ikimashita. They're like, la-di-da! Turns out, watashi, nobody uses watashi, only geeks and people use watashi. It's too formal. Basically, me saying watashi ga toire ikimashita was like going, like, so formal, it was like, your grace. One has left a floater in the commode. Thou must not go in there! You mean Game of Thrones, which would be amazing, of course. There's one particular incident that happened to me which kind of really illustrates my Japanese level. I work in a place called Azabu-Juban, which is a very international area. And you often get drive-bys by these wonderful people, the Japanese nationalists, right? Have you heard the Japanese nationalists before?
Yeah.
Oh man, they're a real treat.
Yeah.
It's weird, I guess because there's so many foreigners around there and they come by like every lunchtime. I work in a school, so when the kids are here, they're like, what is that? Because if you don't know what they're like, my Japanese isn't great, so I can't understand what they're saying, but they're shouting out of this megaphone, out of this van driving past. Now, I wouldn't know what they're talking about, it could be anything, but you kind of just know by the way they're delivering it. Like, there's something about this that makes me think Nazi. Nazis, yeah. Don't understand the words, but they might be Nazis. Also, they have this music, which is kind of like oompa music, like... It's like they raided Hitler's record collection and got Darth Vader to remix it. You don't need to know Japanese to know these people are Nazis. I drive by all the time, and it gets me angry. I don't like that kind of thing. I don't like racism and unfairness, and that kind of thing just makes me upset. Another thing that makes me angry is riding my bike in Tokyo. And I mean, I love riding my bike. Riding my bike is fantastic. It's freeing, it's wonderful, liberating and energetic and good exercise. Just I have a problem with everyone else on the road. That's my issue. Other bikes, other cars, red lights, green lights, children, dogs, whatever you want. It just, they get in my way and it gets me all hit up and angry. So I'm riding my bike along Roppongi and minding my own business on the correct side of the road, doing everything by the book. And this van drives by me. I'm like, fuck's sake. Nearly knocks me off. Damn you, Japanese nationalists. So I decided I'm not going to stand for this. So I gave chase. Got on my bike, I went top speed, it's a very fast bike. I was speeding up next to them, I was riding, and I was like, I'm gonna kill this guy. And I got up and they were still like, this. I'm driving, I'm thinking, I'm gonna drag that guy out of the van, I'm gonna beat the shit out of him, it's gonna be heroic, it's gonna be amazing. Let's keep going. I get closer, and then, now my Japanese is not great, but I can understand a little bit. So I started to finally, everything clicked into place. I could understand what was coming out. And I listened to what they were saying, and this turned out the megaphone was saying this. Yakimo, yakimo, yakimo. Yakimo oishii desho! Yakimo tabetai! It's the sweet potato man! Selling hot sweet potatoes out the back of his van. The Nazis have even gotten to him. Poor sweet potato man's been taken over. He's a Nazi now. So I caught up with him and dragged him out of his van and beat the shit out of him, of course. And that built up an appetite, so I bought a potato. sat down, we had a chat, and well, he had a lot of good points. In short, I've joined. So it'd be good if all of you could leave the country by next week. That would be fantastic. It's for me and my Japanese nationalist friends.